So let's take a look at the front panel of the Clasp hardware. There are five buttons that control all the functions of the Clasp. The first one is the IPS button. This button sets the tape speed of the Clasp so that it matches the tape speed of your tape machine. There are three tape speeds that you can set with IPS. The first one is 30 inches per second. This is the default setting for Clasp when you power it up. When the Clasp is set to 30 inches per second, the countdown timer is going to display 15 minutes. This means you'll have 15 minutes of time on the tape reel. The next IPS setting is 15 IPS, or 15 inches per second. At 15 inches per second, the countdown timer will display 30 minutes of time. The last IPS setting is 7.5 inches per second. This gives you an hour of recording time. The next button is the post button. This stands for post roll. Post allows the Clasp to keep the tape machine rolling and record even after you've stopped Pro Tools. Post roll settings are off, 6 seconds, and 12 seconds. The advantage of using post roll is that it minimizes the wear and tear on your tape deck when you're doing a really fast-paced overdub session. The next button is the monitor button. This controls the monitor modes of the Clasp. There are three basic monitor modes. The default mode is channels 1 through 24. The next mode is channels 1 through 16. This would be used if you're using a 16-track tape deck with a 24-channel Clasp. The next mode after channels 1 through 16 is repro. Repro makes sure that the Clasp does not switch to monitor input signal when you punch in record in Pro Tools. This allows you to only monitor the repro sound coming from the repro head of the tape deck. If you're going to use two tape decks at the same time with Clasp, let's say you had two 24-track machines and two Clasps daisy-chained together, you'd want the monitor setting to be 1 through 24. If you had two 16-track tape decks and two Clasps daisy-chained, you'd want the Clasp monitor setting to be 1 through 16. The next button is the sync button. This is used to synchronize the tape machines with the Clasp. The Clasp can synchronize up to three tape machines. Three tape machines can be stored in the Clasp memory, and you can switch between tape machines by selecting in the plugin. The last button is the return to zero button. This rewinds the tape deck to the beginning of the tape reel.